What is the fascinating backstory behind the naming of the Stan Musial Bridge? Stay tuned. I will give you that answer. Growing up here in the St. Louis area, I learned about hard work from my father, who owned a local waste collection company. I loved attending Cardinals and Blues games whenever possible. Now I spend my time helping others move here and build a life for their families. I'm Bryan Vogt. Come with me as I show you the best of living the St. Louis Metro East lifestyle. Bryan Vogt here. It is the third largest cable-stayed bridge in the United States. It is truly a modern marvel that can be seen from miles and miles away. And even though it's spectacular to look at any time of the day, I believe at night is when it's the most breathtaking. Of course, I'm talking about the Stan Musial Bridge. However, how it got its name is another story, since it was being funded by Illinois and Missouri. Both states had to agree on the name. When the bridge was first proposed, the Veterans of Foreign Wars asked it to be named the Veterans Memorial Bridge. Since the Martin Luther King Bridge was originally called the Veterans Memorial Bridge, until it was renamed in 1968 following the assassination of the National Civil Rights Leader. Both states agreed that that would be part of the name, but they did not agree on what the first name of the bridge would be. Missouri proposed names such as the Ronald Reagan Bridge. Some proposed the Women's Veterans Memorial Bridge. As completion neared, in the art of compromise, it was even proposed to be named the Jerry F. Costello, William Lacey, Bill Clay Sr. Veterans Memorial Bridge for two prominent state politicians. Now, that would have been a mouthful. But as completion neared, fate and sorrow came into play when Stan the Man Musial passed away at the ripe old age of 93. Not only considered the best player the St. Louis Cardinals ever had, but considered by most as one of the best who ever played the game. And to honor not only him as a player, but as a person, both states agree that it should be named the Stan Musial Veterans Memorial Bridge. And for years now and decades to come, it will be the direct route for people from Missouri to head directly to cities such as Edwardsville and O'Fallon, where I have helped countless people buy and sell their homes. And if you know anyone who is looking to take advantage of this crazy market, I would love to help them. To not miss another episode, hit that subscribe button and ring that bell. Until the next time, make it a great day.
Got a question about real estate around the St. Louis Metro East area? Call me, Bryan Vogt, at 618-210-2451. Or, for a free copy of my Amazon number one best-selling book, Ready, Set, Sold, visit my website, bryanvogt.com. Thank you for tuning in. This is Bryan Vogt. Until next time on Living the St. Louis Metro East Lifestyle.